struggled with this year is containing the offensive glass. So that will be an interesting matchup down low in the paint if BW can rebound and make it a game with John Carroll.
Sounds good. We got about a minute left here in the pregame. Why don't we quick give a shout out to our sponsors? Today's Yellow Jackets men's basketball game is being brought to you by Dan Andrews and Olympic Forest Products, a global recycling company. Domino's Pizza and Berea. Call us at 440-891-0030. The Ohio Education Credit Union. Gain the advantage. Also by the Hoffman Group for all of your insurance and risk management needs. Medical Mutual of Ohio, the healthcare provider of Baldwin Wallace University. And the Comfort Inn in Mirabrook Heights, where comfort is just a part of the service we provide our guests. We got 30 seconds here before the national anthem. We're going to take a quick break, and then we'll come back with the starting lineups. Welcome back to BW Men's Basketball on YellowJackets.com. Nice rendition by the national anthem by the BW Pep Band. We're going to take a quick look at the starting lineups. First for the visiting Blue Streaks. At guard, senior number five, Danny Wallach. At guard, junior number 15, David Linné. At guard, senior number 21, Will Starks. At forward, senior number 24, Simon Kucharowicz. And at forward, junior number 45, David Caputo. For the Yellow Jackets, at guard, junior number 1, Zach Brandy. At guard, freshman number 2, Jay Battle. At guard, sophomore number 30, Cam Kuhn. At forward, sophomore number 14, Mike Kaminsky.
tore his ACL, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I know he missed. I looked on the John Carroll website, and he said he missed the entire year. I didn't see why, but they're not going to really tell you it's his knee. Looks like we're ready for the tip. The OAC leader, John Carroll, undefeated, looking to remain that. Tips up, and Kucharowicz easily wins it. David Lanais handling the ball, gives it up to Will Starks. Tries to get it back right into Caputo, but Caputo mishandled the entry pass and BW ball. Carroll looking will continue to press all game. BW easily breaks it, battle on the attack. Takes it all the way, misses the layup. Featheroff with the putback tip in. BW 2-0, 19:40 left in the first half.
Here's Carroll pushing the ball, like we said. They like to get up and down the floor, push that pace, because they know 3, 4, 5 minutes, there's a new group going to be coming in.
Starks hands it off to Lene. Lene inside to Kucharowicz. Kucharowicz takes it to the rack, no good. Offensive rebound to Wallach. Wallach resets the offense, back to David Lene. Lene gets the pick from Kucharowicz, throws up the three, no good. Offensive rebound, Kucharowicz. Tom Heil wanted the over the back. Think he went up clean, but can't. We're going to keep playing. Lene dribbling at the top. Takes another three. No good. Kucharowicz with another offensive rebound. Follows it. No good. Defensive rebound to Zach Brandy. 18:55 to go. Featheroff pump fakes at the top of the arc. Drives the lane, and he's fouled by Kucharowicz. Looks like Kucharowicz might have got some of the mask because he was pulling on it right away.
Number 24.
That could be big if you're John Carroll. I mean, Kucharowicz picking up an early one. We'll see if he picks up a second one early on too, but that could be big. I mean, he's been one of their leading scorers there this year as Featheroff knocks in the first.
3-0 BW, 18:49. Featheroff's a 65% free throw shooter on the season. Second one is up and spins around and drops. Lene pushing it quick across the timeline. Takes it right to the hole, kicks it back out to Starks. Starks pops a three. Got it. 4-3. BW in the lead at 18:35 of the first half. Brandy trying to break the small press against Starks. Crosses the timeline. Starks pressuring. Hands off to Battle. Battle looking, gives it to Kuhn. Kuhn guarded by Starks. Kicks it to Brandy in the corner. Back to Kaminsky on the top, who's not afraid to shoot the three. Kuhn pulls it all the way back up. 9 to shoot on the shot clock. Kuhn looking. He's got 5 to shoot. Kicks it back to Battle for 3. And he buries it from the left corner. 7-3. BW in the lead. 18 to go. Lene already across the timeline. Pushes it in. And he travels. He was looking for the foul, but didn't get it.
Besides that second possession for John Carroll, BW's looked pretty good defensively. They've forced a couple turnovers. They just need to clean up the offensive boards.
Battle inbounds to Brandy. Brandy back to Battle. Battle's going to break the press. Guarded by Wallach. Takes Wallach down the paint and lays it in. 9-3 BW, 17:45 left in the first half. Lene across the timeline quick. Shoots a quick three and gets it. 9-6, 17:35 left to go in the first half. Wallach pressure hard on Kuhn and knocks it out of bounds. Here comes their first line switch. You're going to have number 34, John Cirillo. Number 12, Derek Young. Number 44, Don Hennessy. Number 14, Ryan Farragher, the OAC Player of the Week, and number 11, Antonio Vinovich. Kuhn gets the inbound, going to be trapped. He breaks the trap at him midcourt, kicks it to Kaminsky for three. Kaminsky buries it. BW up 6, 17
7 points already, so.
And a basket good by Ryan Farragher. Randy quickly crossed the feather off across the timeline. Feather off's going to hold it off for battle. Sets the offense. Guarded by Cirillo. Kuhn in the corner. Guarded by Derek Young. Kuhn spins, turns it over. Young quickly up to Vinicek. Vinicek lays it up and good on the fast break. Battle was there but couldn't take the charge. Inbound to Kuhn. Kuhn's going to bring it across the timeline. 15-18, 14-12, John Carroll. That quick, they're back in it. Brandy on the top of the arc. Shoots the three. No good. Rebound goes to Don Hennessy. Quickly across the timeline. Hennessy gets the ball, kicks it back out to Vinicek. Farragher working down Kaminsky, shakes, bakes, underhand reverse layup. That looked like a circus act, but it went in for the OAC Player of the Week.
Pretty good D by Kaminsky. It just made a better offensive play.
14-35, and we're tied at 14s. Out of bounds off of Kuhn's knee on the trap. The trap working for the Blue Streaks. Coming in for BW is Michael Peters and Zach Warner and Brandon Gleam. And the line shift, the starters are back for Carroll.
Pretty good offense if you're the second group there. You went on a 7-0 run to end it. So if you're the second group, you got to be pleased with what you did there.
Kacharowicz kicks it to Starks in the corner and mishandles it out of bounds, BW. You got to be happy if you're Coach Moran that your second team is probably as good or better than most starting teams.
Yeah, that certainly is a big advantage if you're a Division III college team.
Peters breaks the press across the timeline, kicks to Brandon Gleam. Gleam running the offense, kicks it to Kaminsky at the top. Kaminsky bounce pass to Warner. Warner to Gleam. Gleam looking, wanted the three, but backed off it. Now he's going to take it. No good. You're going to get a team rebound to John Carroll. 13:54 to go in the first half. We're knotted at 14s. You'd have to be pretty happy by Coach Heil, too, if your team's playing with intensity right out the gate.
Yeah, it looks like they're falling back into a 2-3 zone to throw John Carroll off his.
That's Kacharowicz going to the paint. That's a tough mark for Kaminsky, who's given at least 2 inches on him, but he was in the paint playing great defense. He just hit him with the hands on the way up. Kucharowicz is going to shoot two from the line. He knocks it down. That's a person you probably want to send to the line, as he's only a 43% free throw shooter.
Yeah, John Carroll doesn't shoot their free throws as high as a percentage as I thought they would. They're only shooting 64% as a team, which is a little unusual for such a good shooting team, as there's a foul called on number 21, Will Starks.
I don't think it's just a reset of the clock. So we're at 16-14, 13:46 left to go in the first half after Kacharowicz knocked down both free throws. Peters gets it into Brandy, guarded by Starks. They trap at the timeline. That's turned over. Starks breaks it up. Linane back to Wallach. Wallach inside to Kacharowicz. Horowitz battled in, got the rebound, but he was out of bounds. One of the unsung heroes for BW is definitely Ryan Walsh. He battles hard. He might not give. He gives up that size to Kaczorowicz, but he had him there. And here comes Fedorov. Fedorov's coming in for Warner. So we're going to go a little big.
This might be the first time all year that they've played together, so it'll be interesting. Fedorov will be the four. He can shoot a little bit. But certainly you're giving up, like you said, some size to those John Carroll bigs.
Peters crosses the timeline, and Lene steals it and then saves it inbounds. Quick pass to Stark to Wallach. Wallach with a fast break layup. 21-14, 12-25 left to go in the first half.
BW needs a basket. I'm pretty sure John Carroll's on a 14-0 run.
Peters breaks the press. Lene knocks it away from him behind. Gets it back into Walsh. Walsh with the basket and good. That could be two on Kaczorowicz. We'll have to wait and see. It's on Caputo, so they're one each for both of the big men, but here comes the line switch. Vinicek, Young, Farragher, Cirillo, and Hennessy. It's going to take me a few to remember who they all are. Walsh looking to complete the three-point play. No good. Rebound to Hennessy. Cirillo. Farragher brings it across the timeline. Kicks it back to Hennessy. Hennessy. Farragher with a jumper. Rebound to Michael Peters.
So it's going to be a tough matchup in this group if you're Fedorov. You're going to have to guard a guard a few times because BW is switching one through four.
Peters with the dribble. He's going to look inside, kicks it back. Looking for help now, finds Walsh underneath. Walsh with a move with a little baby hook, gets it. 21-18, 11:30 to go in the first half. Vinicek handling the ball. Quick jumper for three. No good. Strong rebound by Fedorov. Fedorov finds Gleam. Gleam brings it across the timeline. Takes it into the paint. Kicks it back out to Battle for three. And he buries it. We're tied at 21 and 11:10 left to go in the first half.
7-0 run by Baldwin Wallace there.
Farragher bringing it back up. Takes a jumper over Fedorov. Ball's being battled around on the board. Finally controlled by Hennessy. Kicked back out to Vinicek. Now Farragher dribbles inside. You're going to get a blocking foul. And I don't know who it's going to be on. There was three Yellow Jackets underneath.
Foul by W, number three.
Goes against Brandon Gleam. Subs back in for BW. Kaminsky and Kuhn replace Peters and Walsh. Good time there for Walsh on the floor.
BW certainly matched John Carroll's energy. They had a little lull, but they're right back in it.
Vinicek dribbling at the top. He's looking, gets bumped by Kaminsky, and Kaminsky's not having about it because he knew. That's a quick two on Kaminsky with 10:40 left to go in the first half. That's the fourth foul on BW. Carroll only has two. And Warner's back in immediately for Kaminsky. Feather off at the top of the three. Finds Kuhn. Kuhn's guarded by Starks. 11 to shoot. Back to Brandy. Looking inside finally to Featheroff. Featheroff trapped. It looked like he traveled. Got away. Passes it back to Brandy. Rebound to Caputo. Quickly across the timeline is Lene. Lene dribbling him past Battle. Gets inside. Hands it off to Wallach. Wallach back to... Wallach still has it. Inside to Kucharowicz. Mismatch there between Kucharowicz and Warner. Starks for three. No good. Offensive rebound goes to Carroll off of Battle. Battle thought he had it, but it went right off of him. Lene back into Caputo. Caputo back into Lene. Lene's up, gets Brandy up in the air, waits for him to go over him, puts it in. 26-21, 8:15 left to go in the first half. Battle gets, breaks the press, gets it to Kuhn.
And that's going to be three on Kucharowicz.
Yeah, man, you saw it as quick as I did, Cooper. No, that's two, I think, yeah, because they gave the last one to Caputo. That's right. We thought it was both on Kucharowicz. Ball's inbound to Battle. Battle guarded by Lene. Warner for three out of the corner. He gets it. 26-24 blue streak, 7:50 left to go in the first half. Kucharowicz with a layup. 28-24, 7:40 left to go, first half.
Simon Kucharowicz for two.
Kuhn gets the inbound from Battle and he throws it away, throws it into the BW student section.
Those are the type of turnovers you just can't have if you're going to beat a good John Carroll team.
And the first person out of the non-rotation for the Blue Streaks is in. Brian Papich will replace Kucharowicz, who we probably won't see for the remainder of the half. Caputo looked like he was going to get... Starks got the ball, drives it to the lane. Lefty misses the layup. Rebound to Peters, who just checked back in the game. Brandy across the timeline. Brandy takes it into himself. Basket is good. 26-28. Blue Streaks is still in the lead. 7:10 left to go first half. Lene forces up a three, and he buries it with two guys in his face. 7 minutes left to go in the game, or half, excuse me, 31-26. BW, or Blue Streaks. BW with the ball. Peters across the timeline, closely guarded by Starks, picks up his dribble, finds a cutting Brandy. Brandy finds Featheroff, gets it inside to Kuhn, who's got the mismatch against Wallach. He's taking Wallach to the paint, looking for the foul, but misses the layup. Linane across the timeline already. Quick stop three. No good. Rebound Peters. Peters kicks it quick to Brandy. Brandy gets it across the timeline. Kicks it back to Warner. Warner for three. Buries it from the top of the arc. 31-29, 6:20. Linane across the timeline, kicks it to Wallach. Wallach for a three, buries it. Looks like a game of horse out here. Who can have the better three? Peters will handle the point, bringing it across the timeline. Finds Brandy. Brandy's now going to handle the offense. Calling out. Finds Peters in the corner. Back up to the top to Kuhn. Warner for another three. Missed that one. David Lene with the rebound. Pushes it across the timeline. Inside to Caputo. Layup. That was too easy, Cooper.
The pace of this game is unreal right now. Up and down both ways. Both teams are making some shots. Baldwin Wallace is shooting 41% from three. John Carroll is shooting 50%. So certainly what we expected.
Yes, no doubt about it. I thought we had a timeout on the floor, but everybody switched, so I'm not even going to try. We got everybody back in. I believe the second team is in for John Carroll. There's a wholesale substitution there, Cooper. Gleam throws the pass, and Walsh with a great hustle to try and save it, but Vinacek has the ball, hands it off to Farragher. Farragher finds a wide. wide open Young, who buries the three. John Carroll's largest margin of the game at 39-29 comes at 5:19 left to go in the first half. 30-second timeout called by Tom Heil. We'll stay here.
You know, if you're Ryan Walsh there, he almost would have rather let that ball go out of bounds instead of giving John Carroll a 5-on-4 there. I mean, four guys back on defense, a little shot fake, and then who was it, Faraday?
Derek Young hit that three.
Derek Young, so certainly a wide-open three, and he's not going to miss many of those.
You can't knock Ryan Walsh's hustle,
no.
But on that, like you said, on that situation, probably should have let it go, but
absolutely.
That's not his motor. His motor's running 100%. Every time we play John Carroll in the 4 years that he's been on the court, he flies around, so you're not going to see anything less from Ryan Walsh.
And you don't expect anything less.
Back into play. Kuhn bringing it across, guarded by Vinicek. Kuhn still dribbling. Takes it into the paint. Throws it up. No good. Gets his own rebound. Throws up another one. No good. Walsh there to clean it up and puts it in.
Right on cue.
39-31. 4:55 left to go. And wow. We got Vinicek going in on a layup.
I think the side ref was going to call it a charge, and it was the underneath the ref's call, so he let him call it, but I think he was going to call a charge over on the side.
The BW student section not happy with that. And on all of that, Vinicek threw it in on, to me, a continuation, and it goes in. So 41-31, 4:54 left to go in the first half. Vinicek going to go to the line for one to complete the three-point play. No good. He almost got his own rebound. Goes out of bounds in favor of the Yellow Jackets. Was not sure who picked up that foul for BW.
It's Gleam. Gleam picked up his second.
Okay. Carroll got him with the trap. Backing out the battle. A wide open Peters for three. No good. Defensive rebound to Farragher. Farragher brings it across the timeline. He's quick stop pop at the foul line. Basket counts. And then I think we're going to get a loose ball foul on Hennessy.
I think Walsh, actually.
They did call it on Walsh. Okay. So is that's Walsh's first, team sixth. Walsh goes to the bench. Cirillo will inbound. Looking, still finds Farragher. Farragher's going to handle the point. Kuhn's guarding him, but he's not up on him. Kicks it to Young. Farragher in the corner. Well, they're back in the 2-3. Cirillo hands it off to Vinicek. Vinicek with the crossover dribble. Had Kuhn in the air. Kicks it back to Cirillo in the corner. Cirillo drives, throws up a circus act, and it goes in. 45-31, 4:10 left to go in the first half. Peters quickly across the timeline. Kaminsky in the corner for three. Got it from Warner on a quick pass. Selfish passing on the Yellow Jackets right now.
They had to have that bucket.
Farragher, quick jumper, no good. Kuhn with the rebound. They're coming quick to themselves. Kuhn slows it down, finds Kaminsky. Kaminsky thought about it, drives in, finds Battle for three. No good. Gets his own offensive rebound. Throws up the layup and good. 45-36. 3:35 left to go in the first half. Farragher finds Vinicek. Vinicek going to go to the line. Hole again. Left hand off the glass. Nothing Peters could do there. Vinicek and Battle got tangled up. The referee pulled them apart. And here comes the wholesale substitution for the Blue Streaks. The only one not in the starting lineup is Kucharowicz. That role is still going to be played by Popich for the remainder of the 3 minutes of this first half. Back in is Featheroff. And who was the other person that came in? Was it Brandy again?
Yeah, Brandy's back in.
Okay. Battle finds, looking for Brandy, overshoots him. Caputo takes the ball. He turns it over. Starks tries to save it, and he does. Close to over and back, but he got up in the air. Starks for two, no good. Rebound, Pappage. He, offensive rebound, no. This is first one. Gets the offensive rebound and puts it back in. 49-36, Blue Streaks. 3 minutes left to go in the first half. Brandy back to Battle. Battle brings it across the timeline. He's guarded by Lene. He's in the corner. Finds Kaminsky at the top of the arc. Looking for Kuhn. Kuhn, who's been held scoreless so far. Trying to force the basket there, Cooper, and he gets an offensive foul on the charge.
Yeah, you said it. I mean, he's been pretty quiet in the first half. But, you know, it really being down 13, and you expect Cam to really do something if you want to stay in this game if you're BW.
Lene dribbles inside to Pappage, who on the bounce pass couldn't handle it. Then he picks up the quick foul as Battle stole the ball, and he took a forearm to the chin. Brandy's going to inbound it. We got 2:31 left in this opening half. 49-36 Blue Streaks with their largest margin of lead so far. Brandy gets it into Battle. Battle guarded by Wallach. Starks looking to come for the trap. They got Battle cornered. He picks up his dribble. Kicks it to Brandy. Brandy tied up by Lene. Lene, but Brandy somehow gets away. But they call a 10-second backcourt, which is true. Good defense by the Blue Streaks.
Brandy looked like he may have gotten held there a couple times. I'm not sure if it was all ball or not, but certainly he thought it was more than ball.
Back into action, Lene finds Starks in the corner. Back to Lene, to Caputo, to Wallach. Wallach inside, or Lene inside to Caputo. Caputo with the jumper, no good. Strong rebound for Battle. Battle's going to bring it across. Guarded by Lene. He's taking him all the way to the paint. Blocked by Pappage right on the glass. I'm not sure if that was not goaltending. Caputo inside working Featheroff. Featheroff had great defense, but Caputo lays it in. 1:50 left to go in the first half. 51-36 Blue Streaks, adding to their largest lead.
BW needs to go on a little bit of a run here down the half. They got to get it down to 10.
Kuhn looking. They're looking for him to shoot, but he gets caught off by Pappage. Pappage, or Kuhn finds Kaminsky. Three-pointer on its way, no good. Lene with the rebound. He's going to bring it right across. Lene's dribbling. Starks has the ball now, finds Pappage. Pappage kicks it back out to Wallach. Wallach for three. He gets it. 54-36. 1:10. Timeout, BW. It's a full timeout. We're going to take it with them. Blue Streaks lead the Yellow Jackets 54-36 on BWYellowJackets.com. BW Men's Basketball on BWYellowJackets.com. I'm Jeff Miller, and joined by my partner, Cooper Moretz. 54-36, 1:10 left to go in the opening half. Blue Streaks with their largest margin of lead so far this game. And they're shooting the lights out, 53% so far, 22 of 41. BW's not far behind them at 46%, so that it's surprising that they're not that close. Battle brings it across the timeline. The second team, as we'll call them, for the Blue Streaks are in. Young guarding Battle. Battle takes him to the hole. Blocked by Cirillo. Cirillo grabs his own rebound. Kicks it to Vinacek. Vinacek brings it across the timeline quickly to Cirillo, to Young. Young pulls back, takes the three in front of Kaminsky, misses it. Rebound by Kuhn. Cam Cameron Kuhn across the timeline, looking, drives it in, loses the handle, kicks it back to Brandy. Brandy into the corner to Battle. Battle guarded by Farragher, the OEC player of the league. We got 25 left in the first half. 12 on the shot clock. Cirillo jumps out on Battle. And Battle's going to pick up the quick offensive foul. Coach Heil not happy about that.
That's a tough call from Jay Battle. I mean, hard hedge. There's going to be contact, but was there enough contact to make him fall?
I'm not sure about that either, Cooper. Was it one of those maybe no calls? 19 left to play in the half. Carroll will look for the last shot. They brought back their starters. With the exception of Pappage, Hennessy, and Cirillo are on the floor. They didn't bring them all back. I guess they brought the shooters back. Lene brings it in. Circus Act layup, no good. Brandy's going to get one off to Kuhnfer at the buzzer for three. No good. Had a good look at it. Went in and out. 54-36 at the half. We're going to take a break. We'll come back with some first half stats. Get ready for the second half. You're listening to BW Yellow Jackets Basketball on BWYellowJackets.com. BW Men's Basketball on BWYellowJackets.com. I'm Jeff Miller, joined by my partner, Cooper Moretz. It's halftime here in this OAC Crosstown Rivalry game. The Blue Streaks lead the Yellow Jackets 54-36. Today's BW Yellow Jacket Men's Basketball game is being brought to you by the Oriole Cafe, a great place for sports. The Cleveland Clinic Sports Health Division, the healthcare provider for BW Athletics. Parkway Auto Care in Berea, Strongsville Express Tire and Auto Service in Montville. American International, when you require a company with proven performance, offered by Marriott and Town Suites in Middleburg Heights. Have you stayed at a Marriott today? Cooper, let's take a quick look at the first half stats. I'll quick go over the John Carroll guys. Carroll shooting 22 of 43 for 51.2% from the field. They're 8 of 15 from 3 at 53.3%. And they're 66% from the foul line at 2 of 3. Pretty evenly keeled for them across the board, like we all know that we said that in the pregame that, well, most of you didn't hear, was six double-figure scores, but they're led by Danny Wallach with 8 points and David Linane with 8 points. Then you have 1, 2, 3, 4 guys with 6 points and 3 guys with 4 points. It's pretty impressive that for their 54 points that it's evenly that spread. What we talked about them being the leading rebounding team and keeping them off the glass in the first half didn't go the way the Yellow Jackets wanted, as they grabbed 25 total rebounds, including 10 offensive. They handled the ball very well. They only turned the ball over 7 times in the first half, so that's a key. They're looking to go quick, so it's hard for the BW defense to set up and look for them to cause a turnover because it's that they're already gone. So, Cooper, why don't you give us what's going on with the Yellow Jackets?
Thanks, Jeff. BW was led by Jay Battle. He had 12 points. Then after that, we had 3 guys with 6 points. Zach Warner hit a couple threes. Mike Kaminsky hit a couple threes. And then Ryan Walsh went 3 of 3 from the floor for 6 points. As far as a team, BW shot 14 of 32 for 43.8% from the floor. 6 of 17 for 35.3% from 3. And 2 or 3 of for free throws. I think the big glaring stat, though, for Baldwin Wallace is that you have the OAC leading scorer, Cam Kuhn, had 0 points in the first half of a 0-4 shooting. You know, and we talked about it pregame, like Jeff said, but the OAC leading scorer shouldn't have 0 points at halftime. He's averaging, 21-plus a game, and to be down 18 at this time, you're really digging yourself a pretty big hole against a really good John Carroll team. So if Baldwin Wallace wants to have any success in the second half and to make this game closer, Cam Kuhn's going to have to do what he's capable of.
You're definitely right there. Like I said before we went to the tip, that he's struggled, teams have keyed on him in the in the last OAC games. We've gotten to OAC play recently, and the teams know who's going to be shooting for BW. And after the 51-point school record performance against Mountain Union early in the season, they know who's going to shoot the ball, and the OAC leader is who they're going to key on. Jay Battle stepped up, but somebody else has to join him for the Yellow Jackets to overcome this in the second half.
Yeah, I mean, you'd think it'd be Cam Kuhn. You know, Jake Featheroff is very capable of having a big game. Really, any of the guards, from Brandy to Gleam to Peters, and even Warner is very capable of knocking in shots. So certainly, I wouldn't say it's over for BW, but definitely you're hitting the panic button, and you definitely need to, like Jeff said, get those stops at the defensive end and to really just rebound better. I mean, you gave up 10 offensive rebounds to John Carroll. If they can do that and they can kind of chip away at this lead, I mean, obviously there's no 18-point bucket, so you got to chip away. You got to do it one possession at a time. So BW can have that mindset, and if they can execute in the second half, they're very capable of making this a game.
You're definitely right. The Yellow Jackets are always great 3-point shooting teams, so you're never out of a game. You're only 6 3-pointers behind, but you know, anything's possible. They can't come out flat. If they do, it could be
feet from the basket. So if they can limit those in the second half, like you said, anything's possible when you're a good three-point shooting team.
And like we were talking about point production, we already knew that they're a platoon team at Carroll. They got 24 bench points to BW's 12. Right there is a key that second team is really coming in and can do it. You're looking at them, there's only three guys that are played 11 minutes or more. BW has Cam Coon played 18 of the 20 minutes. Featheroff played 16. Battle played 16. Brandy played 14. And Kaminsky played 11. So our starters are tired. And that you, like you said, the intensity that Carroll brings with both their lines is something that you're going to have to keep up with. And great game off the bench for Warner and Walsh. You expect to get 12 points in the first half of. You expect maybe to get 12 points out of them out of the entire game. But you need somebody else to step up and help out there. And it's got to come from your starters. Can't have one guy with 0 points. Your two leading scorers have a combined 4 points. So you're gonna have to look for some other ways to score.
I mean, yeah, you said it. I mean, you're not gonna win very many games when your two leading scorers and two of the top players in the OAC only have 4 points. But I mean, you gotta give credit to John Carroll though. I mean, they played 11 guys in the first half. All of them getting at least 5 minutes of playing time, and you know 10 of them scored. So, if you're John Carroll, that's exactly what you wanted to do to come in here and to get your 16th victory. I mean, really, it's really unique what they do. I mean, you don't see it a lot in college basketball to have 11 solid guys that are capable of really. Any one of them is capable of going off on a nightly basis. So, I mean, when you try to game plan for that, if you're Baldwin Wallace, it's tough. I mean, give BW credit for, I mean, kind of hanging around for most of that first half. But, you know, John Carroll, it is a game of runs, and John Carroll did go on a couple of big runs there in the first half. So, second half is going to hopefully a different story for Baldwin Wallace.
Yeah, you're definitely right there, Cooper. We got 3 minutes left, about 3.5 minutes left before the second half. We're going to take a quick break. We'll come back with second half action. You're listening to BW Men's Basketball and OAC rivalry action on BWYellowJackets.com. by Medical Mutual of Ohio, the healthcare provider of Baldwin-Wallace University. The Comfort Inn in Middleburg Heights, where comfort is just a part of the service we provide our guests. The Oriole Cafe, a great place for sports. And last, the Cleveland Clinic Sports Health Division, the healthcare provider for BW Athletics. All right, we're underway for second half. Battle tries inbound, finds Featheroff. Featheroff kicks to Brandy. Brandy running the point now, guarded by Wallach. Kicks it to Battle. Battle's going to pull it back, 15 to shoot. Takes it to the hole, finds a cutting Kuhn, kicks it back out to Brandy. Brandy to Kaminsky. Kaminsky for three, in and out. Rebounded by Caputo. Here comes Lene with a quick push. Coast to coast layup, no good. Rebound, Featheroff. Featheroff, quick outlet to Battle. Battle finds Kaminsky in the corner. He takes it inside. Jump stop, kicks it back out to Battle at the top of the arc. Battle for three. No good. Kaminsky had it, lost it to Caputo. Caputo to Lene. Lene running to a streaking Kucharowicz, who missed the bunny. Rebound to Battle. Battle kicks it to Kuhn. They're quickly across the timeline. Kuhn stops, looking, finds Featheroff. Featheroff back to Battle. Battle's going to take it inside the lane. Layup, good. High off the glass. 54-40, or 54-38, 18-46. Starks for three all the way on the opposite end. Buries that. 57-38, 18-41. Back into the press is the Blue Streaks. Broken by the Yellow Jackets. Kuhn at the top, working against Linane. Kuhn spins in the lane, tied up by Linane. Linane's going to pick up the foul.
Pretty good move by Kuhn. It's good to see him getting going early, trying to get his first points of the game.
Kuhn, an 87% free throw shooter on the season. Going to the line. First one's on its way, and good. The OEC leading scorer picks up his first point of the contest at the 18-29 mark of the second half. Second up and good. 57-40, BW 18-25. Linane across the timeline inside, blocked by Featheroff. Kucharowicz crashes the glass, loses it, and unfortunately Featheroff was standing out of bounds and got hit with it. And the second team of the Blue Streaks are in. Hennessy, Cirillo, Young, Farragher, and Vinacek. Saying that the shot clock shouldn't be reset. Referees are going to go to the timers table and tell us what's going on. 18-19 left to go here in this OAC crosstown rivalry. You're the fifth-rated Blue Streaks leading your Yellow Jackets 57-40. Pretty decent crowd here tonight, Cooper. I haven't seen Ersprung filled this many people since probably that Swarm the Gym game that they had 2 years ago against these very Blue Streaks.
Yeah, it's certainly a big rivalry in the game and certainly on campus as well. A lot of student support. Looks like almost a couple hundred students in our student section and probably 1,000-plus crowd in Ersprung overall. So it's a big game. I mean, John Carroll's undefeated. Everyone wants to come out and see the best.
Definitely right. Cirillo to inbounds. Finds Hennessy back into Cirillo. Cirillo working Kaminsky. Pump fakes him, gets underneath him, and lays it in. 59-40, 18-10 left to go. Battle going to be guarded by Vinacek. Battle crosses the, throws a long pass to Kaminsky, back to Kuhn. Kuhn going to handle the point. Picks up his fast break push. Pulls it back. Thought better of it. Finds a battle cutting behind. Battle now going to run the point. Finds another feather off running down the paint again, but couldn't convert. Gets fouled.
Pretty good find by Jay Battle there. But they've, on the defensive end, I'm surprised Jay Battle didn't get picked up for a foul there underneath the basket. He went up and gave, I'm not sure who it was under there, but he gave him a little bit of a piggyback ride, his feather off connection on the first one.
Feather off second offering on its way and good. He's 4 for 4 from the line for the game so far. Farragher across the, I can't keep up how quick they move across. Cirillo in the paint. Foul's going to be picked up by Fellerhoff, but I think he got hit on his nose again.
Yeah.
I think he got underneath that mask, but he looks all right. He's back up on his feet. 61-44, 17:09 left to go in this one. Cirillo on the line. Missed the basket, rebound, Vinicek, and good.
Another offensive rebound for John Carroll.
Battle trying to break the, gets across the timeline, excuse me, I thought there was the trap was coming. Vinicek just guarding him by himself. Cirillo goes to the deck. Battle finds Kaminsky in the corner, back to Brandy. Brandy's going to take it down the lane. Left-hander, no good. Featheroff gets the offensive rebound and puts it back in. 63-46, 16:35. Farragher between the legs. He's got Battle all over the place. Runner, no good. Rebound, Cirillo, no good. Battle with the defensive rebound.
BW was fortunate there. That was an easy one for Cirillo.
Kuhn with the shot, no good. Hennessy with the rebound. Vinicek on the push. Finds a streaking Farragher who turns it over. Nope, one off of Kaminsky. Got Blue Streaks got lucky there. First team is back in, as well as Walsh and Gleam for the Yellow Jackets. Caputo, Kucharowicz, Starks, Wallach, and Linane are back on the floor for the Blue Streaks. 16:10 left to go in this one, 63-46. Linane inbounds, kick to Kucharowicz, right back to Linane. Linane takes it in the lane. Finds Charowitz, no good. Gets an offensive rebound. Tried to throw it back up. Missed it and rebound to the Yellow Jacket. Battle takes a three, and he buries that. 63-49, 15:50 left to go. Caputo takes it to himself. Gets fouled by Kaminsky or Walsh. Let's see who they give it to. They gave it to Walsh. His second, team second. Caputo going to the line for the first time tonight.
The game slowed down a bit compared to the second half, or compared to the first half. It was really up and down there early on and late as Caputo misses the first one. I'm not sure if that was, if that's adjustments by BW or John Carroll, but certainly hasn't been as fast as the first half.
Definitely right there, Cooper. It looks like the Yellow Jackets are trying to control the pace. Blue Streaks are still, their first team's still running pretty fast. Caputo's second one is no good. Starks with another offensive rebound for John Carroll. Linane with a quick three, no good. Gleam tracks it down. He's going to push it quickly across the timeline. Put himself in the air where you don't want to be. Caught in no man's land, throws it away.
Yeah, Simon there was on his heels, and I'm not sure if he knew that he was there, but certainly if you're BW, you got to talk and let your teammate know.
You're definitely right. Maybe he felt Kucharowicz behind him. Caputo gets it into the paint, working Walsh. Puts it up. Good defense by Walsh. Walsh with the defensive rebound. Battle's going to bring it across the timeline. Finds Warner in the corner for three. 63-52, 15 minutes left to go in this one. BW student section trying to get the team in it. Wallach with a deep three, no good. Warner with the rebound. Good defensive stop for the Yellow Jackets.
defense by Brandon there. Got his chest in front, drew the charge, and second team's back in for John Carroll.
Along with Michael Peters for the Yellow Jackets. 14:36 left to go, 63-52. BW trying to break the press into Gleam. Gleam guarded by Vinacek. Gleam's pass almost stolen, but they get across the timeline. Warner picks up his dribble, finds Gleam. Gleam guarded by Farragher. Gives it to Kuhn. Kuhn working Farragher now. Farragher's going to pick up the foul. I believe it's his first, team's fourth. 14:17 left to go. BW inbound from the side. Kuhn into Walsh. Walsh kicks it back to Kuhn. Kuhn forcing up a jumper. Not even close, but Cirillo can't handle it. BW gets lucky on an errant shot there by Kuhn. Cirillo just couldn't drill it in.
Yeah, I can understand the frustration if you're Cam Kuhn only, or not scoring in the first half, but you can't force tough shots like that if you expect to get back in the game.
You're definitely right. He's forcing the ball when he shouldn't be. He did on the first half a little bit too much, too. Gleam looking to inbound, getting stuck there. Gets it finally into Warner. Warner kicks it to Brandy. Brandy grinded by Vinacek. Switched off by Hennessy. Got the mismatch there. And it's back to normal. Peters at the top. He's working Cirillo. Takes it to the paint. Cirillo gets the block from behind. Vinacek going to bring it quickly across the timeline. Vinacek finds Farragher. Farragher for three. That's a dagger that you didn't need after a great offensive chance down at the end. Brandy going to bring it across the timeline. Brandy picks up his dribble, gets it to Walsh. Walsh back to Peters. Peters finds Gleam for three. Short ironed it there, but ball's loose, and Warner picks up the loose ball. Gleam back in the paint, kicks it back out to Warner. Guarded by Hennessy, who knocked the ball away. Warner's got the ball. 23 to shoot. Gleam going to run the offense. Gleam finds Warner for another three. In and out. That one was deep inside. You're going to get a foul on the rebound by Hennessy. Against Walsh.
Foul John Carroll, number 44.
Like you said earlier, I mean, Walsh is just working his butt off down there.
And he's doing it, and you know what? He's putting the big men in foul trouble. Now Hennessy has two. Team fifth. And Gleam turns it over, but Warren, nope, it's still loose. Everybody's all over the ball. That was just a who wanted it, and nobody wanted it. Went off the blue streak's foot and out of bounds. BW maintains position with 28 seconds to shoot. 12:57 left to go in this one. Blue streak's up 14, 66-52.
Nice job by Warner there to keep it alive.
Another hustle guy that you don't see a lot of them in the book. Feather off inside, back to Warner for three. Off the iron. And Gleam with a hustle for the offensive rebound and then gets fouled.
Six fouls already for John Carroll.
Cirillo picks up his second. Yeah, I don't think they had that many in the first half. They had five fouls in the first half alone. They got six already in the first 7 minutes. Brandy going to run the point. Cirillo jumps out on him. Blocked by Hennessy. Vinacek going to bring it up quickly. Dribbles between his legs. Finds a cutting Farragher. Farragher with a jumper. Good. 68-52. 12:30 left to go. Farragher going to come up on Peters. Peters going to dribble across. He breaks the timeline and the press. Hands it off to Brandy. Brandy guarded by Derek Young. Hennessy jumps out on him. Back to Warner. Gleam handles it now, looks for the three, and he buries it. 55-68, blue streaks. 12 minutes left to go in this one. Vinacek hands it off to Young. Young back to Farragher. Farragher back to Young.
matching BW right now. I mean, 16-point game, that's 18 points at halftime, but still, whenever they need a shot, they get it.
Gleam goes into the paint, finds Peters. Peters brings it in. Hennessy, he buries the circus layup. Hennessy's going to pick up his third.
You got to wonder when the first group's going to come back in. I don't know what Coach Moran saw in that first group, but he's sticking with the second group here halfway through the second half.
Or is this going to be Pappage back in, or are you going to get another big guy? We're going to see their 12th player off the bench. Peters looking to complete the three-point play, and he does it. Hennessy with the defensive rebound. Farragher brings it across the timeline. Vinicek with the ball, dribbling against Gleam, steps back for a two and misses it. Brandy with the defensive rebound. He's pushing it quickly. He's got nobody with him, but he finds Gleam in the corner. Gleam going to take it inside, kicks it back to a wide-open Warner. Vinicek jumps out on him. He got the shooter's roll of earth sprung there. The home friendly roll was down, came up, and went back in. 71-60, Blue Streaks, 10:45.
Looks like he was in the circle there.
Yeah, I think that's what the referee was pointing at. Cirillo was going up, and Featheroff's going to pick up his second foul. Team's third. You asked when they were coming in. 10:45 mark. Here they come. The first teamers. But Cirillo will go to the line for two. Cirillo, an 81.8 free throw percent shooter.
From here on out, BW is going to be shooting free throws.
You are, yeah, they're at the seven mark. Cirillo's first one is up and no good, rattles out. Everybody's coming back in but Caputo, I believe. We got Kaminsky and Battle back in. Kuhn's still on the bench with no points, or with 2 points, excuse me, I'm sorry. Cirillo looking to split the pair. Second one is no good. Featheroff with the rebound. Battle pushes it quickly to Brandy. Brandy thought about taking it inside, but kicks it back out to Kaminsky. Battle now running the point. Battle cuts two people, finds Featheroff for the layup, and good. He's going to get fouled by Cirillo, I believe. That's his third, team A. Featheroff looking to complete the three-point play. He's got 12 now.
Yeah, we mentioned it at halftime. BW needed to chip away at the lead as Featheroff completes the three-point play. Eight-point game, 71-63, with a little more than 10 minutes left in the game.
The student section chanting the defense. Starks for three. No good. Rebound Kaminsky. Good block out of Caputo. Here they come, the Jackets, trying to cut into the lead even more. Battle running point, getting the instructions from Coach Heil. They're looking for the screen, but Kucharowicz jumped out on top of it. Brandy with the ball in the corner, guarded by Lene. Finds Featheroff in the corner. Featheroff now going to take it to the paint. Thought he was fouled, but he just threw it up and no good. Rebound Caputo. Lene quickly across the timeline. Lane still dribbling, takes the jumper, no good. Caputo, offensive rebound, tipping, good. 73-63, 9:30 left to go in this one. Battle finds Kaminsky for three, he gets it. 73-66, 9:18 left to go in this one. Don't go anywhere, folks. Lene got Featheroff in the air. Finds Starks. Back out to Wallach. Wallach finds Caputo. Caputo. Back out to Wallach. Wallach for three. No good. Rebound to Featheroff. Looks like the Blue Streaks have kind of lost their composure on the offensive end.
You wonder if Coach Moran's going to take a timeout. He hasn't yet in the game, but certainly a BW. Oh, and there's a steal by
Linane.
2 points easy.
I was wondering if he was going to dish it back to cutting Kacharowicz for a massive dunk, but he took it down to the hole himself. Now the press is back on. Here they are, but get it. Gleam gets it into Battle. Battle back to Gleam. Gleam throws it in the corner to Fedorov. Fedorov gets it to Kaminsky with the reverse layup, and good. 75-68, 8:15 left to go in this one. Lane trying to split two BW defenders, and he loses the ball. Fedorov picks it up off the ground, gives it to Gleam. Gleam right across the timeline. He's going right to the hole. Kicks it back out to Kaminsky. Kaminsky finds Gleam in the corner for three. He gets it. 75-71, Yellow Jackets. Coach Heil with the timeout. 7:56 left to go in this one. 75-71, Blue Streaks.
BW has already scored 35 points in the second half. They scored 36 points at halftime to John Carroll's 21 points here in the second half. So certainly a huge run by the Jackets. And that's what we talked about at halftime, and that's what you had to do if you were Coach Heil and the basketball team.
You're definitely right, and they're doing it without the OAC leading scorer, who's been on the bench since probably, I want to say, at least the 13-minute mark. So the last 6 minutes, they've made their run without the OAC leading scorer.
Yeah, you have Jay Battle leading the way at 17. Then you have Kaminsky and Fedorov with 13 apiece. So we talked about other guys needing to step up, and Kaminsky and Fedorov are doing that.
Kaminsky having a big game against the Blue Streaks, like his father, the Hall of Famer, had many times in his career here at BW. The transfer making his mark known again in his first game against the Blue Streaks ever in his collegiate career, because he played for Coach Heil at Defiance last year, and they didn't face the Blue Streaks. And the second team is back in, and here we go again. Cirillo with a quick lay-in from Vinicek. Kuhn is back on the floor, 77-71. 7:40 left to go in this one. Battle quickly across the timeline. Battle's dribbling, pulls up, picks up his dribble back to Kaminsky. Battle's gonna reset the offense, 15 to shoot. Battle still dribbling, looking for somebody now. He picks up his dribble, finds Brandy. Brandy back to Battle. Brandy for three as the clock expired. 77-74, 7:10 left to go in this one. Check for three. He gets it, and it answers right back, 80-74. Coach Hiles high about something on the defensive end there. Battle handles the ball.
They've run this double screen a couple times tonight. See what they do out of it.
Farragher jumps it out, jumps on top of it. Battle picks up his dribble. Brandy with the left hand going inside. Runner no good. Hennessy with the rebound. Forced that layup there. Vinicek quickly across. Finds Farragher, gets Kuhn up in the air. Takes it to the foul line, pops, drops it. 82-74, 6:17 left to go in this one.
5-0 run out of the timeout.
And it's the second team again, looking like the better team in some spurts here tonight for the Blue Streaks. Battle brings it across, guarded by Young. Finds Fedorov with the jumper, doesn't get the friendly roll. Rebound by Farragher. Farragher quickly across to Vinicek. Vinicek.
Charge.
He's getting the charge, and Battle looks like he took an elbow to the face. He's down, but we'll see what happens. For the Blue Streaks. That's good. Hennessy battling Kuhn, and they're going to call him for the offensive foul on the loose ball. I think that's four on Hennessy.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. I'm not sure if Cam really had position there, and really Hennessy was just taller. I mean, I think that's why he got the rebound. I don't think there was any more contact than usual.
I'll give Kuhn. He took it from the book of Steph Curry, the flop. He went falling down like most NBA players do. Kuhn going to the line looking for his third point of the game. And it's good. Kuhn's not shooting well from the field, but he can remain perfect at 4-for-4 from the line if he knocks down this second. Second offering's on its way and good. 82-76, 5:25 left to go in this one. Cirillo kicks it to Papich. Papich back up to Farragher. Farragher inside to Cirillo. Takes it by Fedorov, but misses it. He thought Fedorov was going to come at him, and Fedorov just let him go by. Kuhn brings it across the timeline. Guarded by Papich. Kuhn now has a taller Hennessy on him. Stops for three. No good. Rebound Vinicek. Here he comes quickly across the timeline. Hands it off to Farragher. Farragher gets the pick from Hennessy. Hennessy inside to Cirillo, back out to Vinicek. Vinicek finds Farragher. They reset, 18 to shoot. Farragher has the ball now. Inside to Cirillo with a jumper from the foul line, good. 84-76, 4:37 left to go in this one. Timeout, John Carroll. I believe it's a 30-second timeout. All he's doing is calling timeout to do the line shift. That's all it was. All he wanted was a quick substitution. So we're not going anywhere, folks.
That's all he's done all game.
First team is back in. Kucharowicz, Caputo, Linane, Starks, and Wallach, the starting five. Battle going to bring it against Linane. Crosses the timeline. Battle looking for somebody to help him out. Linane's going to pick up the forearm shiver. He picks up his third.
He's going to get two free throws, too.
Number 15, Shane Battle to the line.
The Yellow Jackets, we talked about this. They're going to knock down these the rest of the way out if they want to stay in this one and get or even take the lead over. First one's on its way, and good. Mr. Hustle back in the game for the Yellow Jackets, Ryan Walsh. That'll be good for the offensive and defensive boards and everything else. He flies around, folks. Battle going to look to complete the two from the foul line. Second one's on its way, and good. 84-78. 4:20 left to go in this one. Linane handling the ball. He's going to take it right past Gleam. Nobody was looking to help out either. That was too easy. 4:10 left to go, 86-78. Now the press turns it over again. Linane going to slow it down. The Blue Streak bench went crazy on that one. Linane now with the jumper. He's no good with that one. Caputo and Kucharowicz using their height advantage to win that offensive rebound. Carroll's going to play times now, it looks like. I think they might use clock, but then again, they're a quick team. Who knows? Linane already shoots the three with 18 to shoot. Caputo another offensive rebound. They're going to call a foul on Walsh.
LBW, number 25.
He picks up his third, just the fourth team foul. BW's defense has picked it up in the second half, and they're not committing the chippy fouls.
Bad sequence for them, though. A couple offensive rebounds and a turnover.
Kucharowicz takes the inbounds, and all Walsh could do was quick foul because he couldn't, the height advantage there, that was going to be an easy bucket. Good foul on if you're Walsh. Not good because he picked up his fourth, but good for the BW defense.
Yeah, he's only shooting about 44% on the year, so.
I think he missed both of them in the first half. Second one's no good. Fedorov checks back in for Walsh. Walsh might not be seen again, but you never know if they need a quick stop. Kucharowicz hits his second. Seven, 78, 3:35 left to go. Battle guard by Linane. pushing off on them. They're going to let that go. Cuts the timeline. Kuhn has the ball. He's going to look and drive. He takes a nice move. Then he throws up a circus act that he shouldn't have. He should have pulled it back down. And defensive rebound to Kacharowicz. Wallach got the wide open three, buried it. 90-78. John Carroll, 3 minutes left to go. Battle going to bring it quickly across the timeline. Kacharowicz picks up a foul at the top of the arc against Battle. And the John Carroll coaches are not happy with it. That's his third. Team like 12th, 15th.
They're shooting two. That's all I know.
They'll be shooting two for the last 3 minutes. Battle back at the line. First offering, no good.
PW's 11 of 14 after that free throw on the day.
Second one is, spins around and drops. Linane going to handle the offense. Battle's going to pick him up at the timeline, and he fouls him quickly. I think we're going to a hack-a-shack approach for the next. They got one more to give, or two more. They got one to give.
Try to extend the game. I mean, Kacharowicz is in. You certainly look to foul him.
90-79, 2:50 left to go. Now they were going to pull off. Linane gets right by Gleam again. Featheroff's there this time. Wallach wide open for three. No good. Kacharowicz out, rebounds Featheroff. That's who they wanted to foul. You got it right there, Cooper. That's who they're going to try and foul the rest of the game. Linane going to work some clock. 20 to shoot. 2:28 left in this one. Linane takes Gleam right by, and I don't know who they got the foul on, but Gleam came back out of nowhere and had all ball in my eyes from this angle.
Warner may have been there with the body.
They nope. gave it to Gleam, so he must have had his arm that we didn't see. 2:22 left to go in this one. Blue Streak's lead is back up to 11. 90-79, and Linane looking to add to it with two from the foul line. First one is up and good. The second team is back in. Farragher will wait for Linane. Cirillo, Hennessy, Vinacek, and Papich. I don't think we're going to see Derek Young anymore. Linane's second offering, good. 92-79, 2:22 left to go. Farragher checks in. The OEC Player of the Week. Kuhn inbound, guarded by Cirillo, taking the ball. Finds a cutting back, Featheroff to Gleam. Gleam breaks the timeline, guarded by Vinacek. Gleam still with the dribble. He thought about a three, but kicks it to Battle. Battle working against Papich. Gets into the lane, hands it off to Featheroff with a layup. 92-81, two left to go.
If you're Coach Hiley, you got to think about fouling. 11-point deficit with under two to play. You got to think that he's going to start fouling soon.
They're going to a man, and I'm not sure they know who they want to foul because Kacharowicz isn't on the floor. Farragher pops from the foul line, no good. Battle gets the long off the defensive rebound. He's pushing it quickly. Guarded by Farragher. He lays it in and good. 83-92. Blue Streak's up with a minute 30 left to go in this one. Timeout, John Carroll. Is this just a substitution timeout? Yes, it is, folks. While we got a quick break, we're going to take time to thank some of our sponsors. Today's Yellow Jackets men's basketball. more to give before that. 44.6 left to go. You got some of the second team, some of the first team. They're moving in and out here. Is the Coach Moran looking to keep BW on their toes? Kurcharowicz, it knocks it down and gives the to the BW student section. Second offering on its way, and he knocked them both down. He's having a pretty good game from the line. I'm not too quite sure. I'm trying to look real quick here what he's from the line today.
4 or 5.
That's impressive for a man that only shoots 43%. Battle breaks the timeline, guarded by Vinicek. Quick three for Battle, and he nails it. Timeout coming for BW. 96-86, 35.5 left to go. It's a full. We're going to take one with them. We'll be right back on BWYellowJackets.com.
Six.
numbers like they